Greetings, my name is Tebogo Chabiko. I come from Zimbabwe. Today I'm going to give you a brief history about Zimbabwe and the legacy of how cities in Zimbabwe were named. First things first, we'll start with a brief history of Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is known to have had a number of kingdoms before it was the Zimbabwe we know today. The first known kingdom was the Mapungubwe Kingdom, which gave way to the Great Zimbabwe Kingdom, which is, I guess, one of the most famous kingdoms in Zimbabwe because of its tunnels. What followed next were the Mutapa Kingdom, the Rozu Kingdom, and then the Ndebele Kingdom. After that, the British came and colonized Zimbabwe. The British arrived in Zimbabwe in 1890. They formed treaties with the Ndebele, where they claimed they wanted mining rights and land for agriculture. They were given these, but what the Ndebele didn't realize was that this was a ploy to steal Zimbabwean land. When they realized this, it was too late. The land was gone. Zimbabwe was colonized. So from 1890 to 1980, Zimbabwe was under British rule. It was colonized. But after a long protracted war, which started in 1966 up to 1979, Zimbabwe won its independence, and its first leader was Robert Gabriel Mugabe. Having given you a brief overview about the history of Zimbabwe and its colonization, let's go back to the legacy of the naming of some of the cities in Zimbabwe. We'll look at Harare, Bulawayo, and Victoria Falls. But for now, let us start with the capital city, Harare. Harare, which means city of no sleep, was named after a local chief, Chief Harare, who is rumored to have not slept. Thus, the city was called Harare. True to its name, Harare is always bustling with life anytime you visit. If you go at midnight, people will be busy in the streets. If you go early in the morning, people will be busy in the street. So that it fits that it's called Harare. Harare is called the Sunshine City of Zimbabwe because of its beauty and splendor. Harare was once ranked one of the best cities in Africa at its peak. Harare is the capital city of Zimbabwe with a population of about 2 million. It used to be called Salisbury when it was colonized, Salisbury in honor of the British Lord and former Prime Minister of Britain, Lord Salisbury. Journeying to the south from the capital, we arrived to the city of Bulawayo, or Bulawayo. Bulawayo is Zimbabwe's second largest city. It is the industrial hub of Zimbabwe. Bulawayo is also dubbed the city of kings and queens after its nobility. Bulawayo is named Bulawayo after a battle in which some Matabele warriors didn't want the then King Mzilikazi's son to take over Lobengula. Lobengula fought with some regiments who didn't want him to take over, but he overcame and conquered them. And it is known that a lot of blood was spilled. So, hence, after he won the battle, he called the city Bulawayo, a place of spilling of blood where he had won. So that is how Bulawayo is named. From the city of Bulawayo, we head to the southwest part of Zimbabwe, to the city of Victoria Falls. The city of Victoria Falls was named in honor of Queen Victoria by the first British explorer, David Livingstone. When he arrived in Zimbabwe and went to the Watonga Gorge, he encountered a majestic and beautiful waterfall, the Victoria Falls. The Victoria Falls is one of the seven natural wonders of the world, and in the local language is called Mosia Tunya, which translates to smoke that thunders. The Victoria Falls is one of the most beautiful falls and cities in the world. It has beautiful views from the water view to the animals, just to the green and lush forest in there. It's like a tropical island in the middle of the savannah. I've been to the Victoria Falls twice, but given a chance, I'll go there again and again. So I recommend, if you ever make a trip down to Zimbabwe, go to the Victoria Falls and see the beautiful place. Thank you for joining me as I spoke a little bit about the history of Zimbabwe and the legacy of the naming of some of the cities in Zimbabwe. I hope to come to you next time with more on the cities and other things about Zimbabwe. This is yours truly, Tapiwa Chabikwa. Have a good day. Bye for now.